We're off and running. Here is Rawat. That is knocked in by Chabot to the corner. Rawat will pick that up. Just couldn't quite get the pass away. Rundon comes. Fire back in. Chance on the doorstep. And a score with just 24 seconds gone in this game. The hustle from the Clan immediately gives them a lead on the road in Dundee. 1-0 Glasgow, 24 seconds gone.
Well, start off as you left last night is exactly what the Clan fans will be thinking about this, and it is the Glasgow Clan's number 7 that opens up the scoring, 4th goal of the season for him. And I'll tell you something, that's a huge one, Dave, in this game that means so much to both teams. An absolute disaster of a start for the Stars. And, well, they've got to find this game quick or it could be a worrying night, you know.
Here is Dixon then. Player coach for the Glasgow Clan. Line change now for the Glasgow Clan. I will flick that one in on a backhand. Puck is loose. Goaltender couldn't hold on. Out for Dixon. Dixon back in, down low. Up in the air it goes, bounces down behind, and the Clan will work this out to the blue line. It's gone over the blue line, though, and they will reset. Oh, hello. Parker is going to go with Kennedy early doors. That'll get the crowd back on side. In the centre then, these two guys grapple on. Parker over the top, takes the helmet off, just waiting to drop the bombs. In they come now. Right hands connect for both players. And over the top with the left for Parker. 1, 2, 3. And they grapple on again. And over the top again from Parker. An uppercut comes in as well. And Parker, down he goes. And the linesman will get involved with that. Neil Parker has done the job. Every single fan in this arena is on their feet.
Well, that was hugely needed, I think, for the Stars here to get this crowd going, Dave. And that was an excellent showing there from Parker. It shows exactly what this game's meaning to him, and it should pick up the Stars now to get their game back on track. I know we're only a minute and a half in and it's crazy to talk that way, but
I don't know if that was arranged or if something happened behind the play. I didn't see anything.
No.
Either way, wow, what a volume in here.
Yeah, it was something I think that needed to pick the home fans up after that.
Yep.
Excellent start from the Glasgow Clan, and well, we talked about the meaning of this game, the importance of this game beforehand, and you can see it in the minute and a half that we've played so far.
Well, we've got some blood on the ice that will need to be cleaned up then. And Kennedy has gone to the dressing room, as you can see. So, get some treatment in there.
I'll tell you something, I wouldn't mess with Parker when he can take you out like that, right?
Yeah, I mean, he's 6'9", so he's dropping that fist down from quite a height.
Exactly.
But the ice techs are on. We'll get things cleaned up here before we get back underway. 1:33 gone in this game. There's a lot happening already.
What a night this is going to be, right? You just know.
Yeah, well, I mean, there's some statistics for both of these teams that are not ideal reading, really.
No, I'm sure.
Goals
sure
against average being one of them.
I'm sure Jeff Mason knows that, and on the other bench there, of course, they do so as well. Of course, I think Sean Boutin, former Dundee Stars player there, holding the fort on the bench.
McPallon caught in possession by Semyonovs, and comes Sanch as well. Trying to chase this one down. Round for Barriga. Barriga will pick up the loose one. Semyonov's in the centre. Goes for Sanch. Sanch out top of the circle. Shot comes in. And Semyonov's in front. Chance has gone. Not across the line. Oh, that one has though. Philippe Sanch turns and smashes that one home. And the DIA absolutely erupts with 5 minutes and 5 seconds gone in this game. Philippe Sanch ties things up. Dundee 1, Glasgow 1.
Well, a huge goal for Philippe Sanch here. For the Dundee Stars to level the game at 1-1. It is Sanj's 8th goal of the season, and that's a massive one, and very, very much a needed one.
I'm quite enjoying this game, I'm going to be honest with you.
I'm thinking it's great. I knew it was going to be like this before, but not like exactly like this, but I knew it was going to be I think what we're seeing is a Dundee Stars team who are hurting from last night, but also probably hurting from that opening goal coming so quick.
Hadn't even really got going, had they?
And that Parker fight, I think, really, really did change the complexion of things for the Stars.
Yep.
Almost in some ways a reality check. Let's get back to business here. And well, one apiece with 14:55 of the first period. Long, long way to go, but I want some more of this. This is an amazing game.
Dow does well, and Leedsman trying to clear the decks. Stars do clear the zone, only as far as McLean, though. Turns and fires it right back in the danger area. There's Roy skipping in, making a nuisance of himself, and the glove is down, I think. No, it's not. From Svensson. Parker trying to shield this up the board without success. Park in behind. Makes to the corner. Chabot plays that one round. Flop out in front and scores! Haddon on the doorstep. Knocks it across the line. And the Clan regain the lead with 12:06 left in the first period. Dundee 1, Glasgow 2.
Well, that's a huge second goal there for the Glasgow Clan. As you say, coming through Haddon, it's his seventh goal of the season. And we'll see it back here. This is good work from the Clan. We know they've got them in this in them. And he puts it into the net and pulls the lead back for the visitors. It is Dundee Stars 1, Glasgow Clan 2. Getting tongue twisted all night with this atmosphere, Dave, and it's mental.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mathieu Roy has been an absolute nuisance in behind the goal. That's two goals have come off the back of that. Chance here for Barriga. Oh, Barriga scores for the Stars and ties things up very quickly. I might need more space on my goal sheet this evening. Dundee 2, Glasgow 2.
Well, let's watch this thing of beauty back from Elijah Barriga to pull the game back to 2-2. It is his 13th goal of the season, and this is a nice bit of play from the Stars as well. The pass laid on there for him, and he has a bit of work to do, but yeah, right past the goaltender it goes, and Elijah Barriga, well, we can see why he is the top point scorer for the Stars, and well, 11:33 left of this period. 2-2.
We're going to need to put the price up for this game. That's it. Charge doubled from now on, I think. This is tremendous.
Yeah. If you ain't enjoying this at home, well, I don't know what kind of elite league hockey games you like watching.
Jones goes D to D. Forechecking again from the Stars, causing Walt some issues this time. Semyonovs has done the job. And Sonj picks up the loose one, pushing this out for Naslund. Naslund gets a chance to shoot here as well, and again, Jones makes the save. Well, Naslund had a good bit of time there. And the Stars shut that move down. So, Stars then get themselves organised. Move out of defence. Semyonovs up the centre, still going Semyonovs, going to get a shot away as well, just in the nick of time. It's taken away from him. And Muse out for Dow, Dow off fire. Sonch trying to redirect it home. And a hand in the air. Sonch has drawn the penalty. Eriksson will take this in close, back out to the line once again. 1:05 left on the PP, shot comes in from a long way, Muse makes the save. Stars though still have possession out to the point. Cross ice for Soke. Soke flicks one in, the redirect chance here. He scores! A power play goal seemed to take her whatever across the line. Everyone in bated breath. I'm sure there was a moment of silence there in the DAA. For 53 seconds to go on the PP. Power play goal, Dundee Stars. Dundee 3, Glasgow 2.
Yeah, well, Dundee Stars taking the lead going into the last 5 minutes of the period. And a huge, huge goal there for Johan Eriksson. It is indeed his first goal for the Dundee Stars, a power play goal as well. And that is a huge one going in to the last 5 minutes or so of this period. It's Dundee Stars 3, Glasgow Clan 2.
Even a sit down after this, yeah. I think. Ah, good. An icing call. That's what we want. Now we can have a break.
I mean, just watching this, if you took out all the goals, it wouldn't surprise you that there's been five goals in a game in a period when everybody's been at it like they have been.
Yeah. Hashtag Dundee Stars Live. Let us know what you think.
Exactly. Definitely let us know what you think.
From the face-off then, out to the point for Massey. Massey will send it back in down the left-hand side, gathered in by County. County makes this out top of the slot. Flicks one, not through traffic. And Parker will exit the zone with this one. Oh, Garrigan takes over. Send it back out. Joe moves in down the left-hand side. Sends it in close. Chanson close again. Oh, good save for Muse. And the rebound is there for the taking, and he's gathered that in as well. Tremendous goal tending from Muse. 3:50 left in the first. Jones straight up the centre. Nice control, and across the line goes Dunbar. Dunbar drops in nicely, and what a save for Svensson that is. Tremendous move, but had and denied by Svensson. From the face-off then. Ingles around the back of the goal here as Semyonovs looks for the outlet pass right onto the stick of Sonj. He's got Buriga in close as well. Got tongue tied there. Sorry about that. Stars on the zone. Sonj. Oh, Semyonovs goes down in the centre. There's a hand there. Yeah, coming this time. This is a trailing ref who's caught that one. Mr. Craig. There was contact with Semyonovs behind the plate. And Jake Bolton not happy about it. Well, Mr. Craig has made the call, so Jake Bolton will sit for two. Soke down low, back out for Soke, top of the circle, cross ice for Dow. Dow will lock this down low for Sonj. Stars move this around. Sonj out for Soke, back to Sonj. Sonj looking for a way through. Down low, Semyonov. Semyonov moves out top of the circle. Centre pass for Sonj. Short, it's gone in! Sonj. I'm sure he's gone to play that across the crease, and it's taken deflection, I think, off the stick of Muse. Either way, it's across the line, and it's 4-2 for the Stars.
Well, it's the second power play goal for the Dundee Stars this evening, and it is Philippe Sonj's second goal as well. Let's watch this back.
Sure, it's taken a deflection off the goalie stick.
Yeah,
oh, no, it's actually Waltz has knocked it across the line.
It's an unfortunate one because, as you say, he was looking to pass that over. And it has just hit the Glasgow Clan player and went into the net. Do we say waltzed into the net, but...
So here's Dunbar from the face-off into the corner, sends it out in front, goes through the blue paint out the other side. Fired back in, it's picked up this time by Semyonovs, sends it through for Buriga. Buriga drops it off lovely for Dow. Dow on the backhand to Buriga, what a goal! What a goal for the Stars! Buriga knocks it across the line with 12:02 left in the second period. Dundee 5, Glasgow 2.
Well, that is a big goal for the Stars here to give the Glasgow Clan a little bit of a mountain to climb, and it's excellent play from the Dundee Stars here. We'll watch this back. Well, you can see it here, Buriga is not the man you want that fall into, but a really good bit of play and build up for that to happen in the first place. We have seen it this year, Dave, that when this Dundee Stars team get on track, and they are, you know, they're looking at it, they're really, really dangerous, and something to go by. Well, looking at this, we could see a furious coach and
yeah, timeout called.
Set of players having to regroup. It's a very wise situation.
It's a combination of Semyonovs and Dow, and onto the stick of Buriga right on the doorstep, absolutely opened up the Clan and gives them a 3-goal lead as well. Timeout called, and back underway very soon.
I'm beginning to like this song more and more as the season goes on, Dave. I wasn't a fan of it before, but...
You don't like it?
No, but sticking in my head. Not this one, I mean the one that was on before it.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I don't like this one because... Yeah.
It's also got stuck in your head.
It does. Anyway, back to play here. Just under 12 minutes of the period left. 3-goal lead the Dundee Stars have at the moment. But Glasgow have showed in this period that they, you know, they're in the right areas. And they get a goal back, changes it.
Oh, nice work there for Dunbar. What a finish from Dunbar. Wow. Roofs that one past Svensson. Goal in, no chance. And the Clan pull a very quick goal back. 11:42 left in the second period. Dundee 5, Glasgow 3.
Well, John Dunbar with his 6th goal of the season. And as we said, you know, the Clan have shown that they could get into positions tonight and punish the Stars. And that next goal was crucial in the game. It shows you that timeout was really, really effective from the Glasgow Clan coach.
Yeah.
John Dunbar with a goal which pulls the Glasgow Clan right back into this one. 5-3 with just 11 and a half minutes left of the period. This game's going to have twists and turns all night, Dave, until the very end, I think.
Yep.
All credit to the Glasgow for getting themselves back into that. It's not easy when you lose the goals they did, but that's a huge one. We'll see how that affects play here and the stamina of both teams.
Wow. Hurlett gives chase, he has held off. Round for Kennedy. Quick pass up, nice control. Chance here from McParland. McParland goes in close. Save from Svensson. And he will cover up as well with Dixon closing in. What a save. Oh, what a move from the Clan. Opened up the chance beautifully.
Well,
and Svensson to the rescue. Goes to the point for Verrier. Verrier will fire. A lot of bodies in there. I'm trying to jam that one home as Eriksson didn't connect. Svensson will activate. Out he comes. Wow, that was a long way out. We saw videos of him doing that when he signed. Everybody heart attacks. Folk does well. Clears the defensive zone. Loses out in the neutral though. And here's Haddon. Handed out in front. Chance. Oh, just past the target. Wow, that was extremely close.
So close.
Howlett comes away with a puck as well. Twists and turns, pops this out to the point for Verrier. Verrier across ice pass for Ingles. Ingles will fire, not through traffic. Garrigan in top of a loose one in the corner. And Parker. Parker protecting this puck around the back of the goal. Under pressure from Waltz and Dixon. And Parker's still going. Trying to dig that puck out of there. And it's Garrigan out for Howlett. Howlett across ice pass for Verrier. Verrier shoots, and the chance was there for the tip for Garrigan. Pressure still on, and the whistle goes. Goaltender is down. Mr. Craig blows the whistle. Hope he's okay down there. He's not moving at all. Don't know if anything untoward happened. Possibly just a collision. On comes the trainer. He's certainly been extremely influential in this game. Seems to have come a cropper there. Comes for Semyonovs. He'll chip it clear. And Sanchez is off and running here with McLean. Sanchez will get there first as well. Oh, Sanchez taking a solo. That's right in front of the referee. No call. Berry will pop this out in front on the backhand. And Hughes shuts the door. Well, Sanchez was looking for a call. And Mr. Craig was right there on the spot. Right in front of him. And no call made. And move this around the offensive zone. Out in front, a quick shot and a good glove save. Well, the puck just fell loose. And a very quick wrist shot. And safely in the glove for Svensson. Ball turn. Nice pass through, but Kennedy can't control. Ingles will send it clear. No, he won't. Kennedy does well. Chance here for Dixon. Shoots one. Big bounce off the goalie and cleared away. Well, Svensson has had a very strong third period for the Stars. Out to the line for McLean, quickly passing it across as well, and blocked in front by Ingles. This time he's taken a sore one on the wrist there, I'm pretty sure. Here comes Barriga though, drops his puck nicely. Semyonov drifting in close, still going. Oh, what a chance that was. And it's bubbled back into the neutral zone. Puck is down, don't know where it is though. It's the Clan, and Muse is off to the bench. Extra skater comes on, and a chance in close. Svensson has sprawled. And Bariga does well, sends it along the board, but the extra skater is on now for the visitors. And a chance here for the Stars to clear the decks. They'll chip it clear. So, this is it then for the visitors. County sends this one round the corner. Leedsman will get there first. Round it comes, sent back in and falls nicely on to the pads of Svensson. Puck drops on the face-off and Svensson will release this one. Chipped away. Well, it's not over the blue line. Roa takes this in close. Body on the line again by Leedsman and puck loose in front here. And Soke will shovel it clear and this time it's across the blue line. And, yeah. Back in possession then. Stars all lose out there. Oh, a chance here perhaps. And it's Parker. He will score. And the Stars put this game to bed with 1:31 left on the clock. Dundee Stars 6. Glasgow Clan 3. Unfortunate set of events there. I think it's Jordan County. He takes a tumble, loses an edge, and Parker has an empty cage to shoot at. And that is game over this evening. 2 points in the bag for the Stars. Barring an absolute miracle for the Clan with 91 seconds left. Colin Joe just holds on to this as long as possible. Makes a red line, dumps it down low. And the crowd are on their feet here in the Dundee Ice Arena. The commentary box is shaking with the noise. And the final buzzer goes. And a final score this evening. Dundee Stars 6, Glasgow Clan 3. Two power play goals this evening for the Stars. And we will get the thoughts of Jeff Mason ringside with Steve.
Well, Jeff, that was a huge way to come back after last night's result.
Yeah, you know, it was a big response. Some guys played really well. Offensively, I thought we were excellent tonight. I'd like to see us clean up some stuff defensively. I think we gave up a little too much. Anton came up with some big saves at times. But obviously a great effort after last night. The fans enjoyed it. So, you know, well done to the guys.
Lost the goal early in the game, which wasn't ideal. But the fight with Ian Parker seemed to spark the game into life for you and then get your game on track.
Yeah, you know, I think Parksy saw it as an opportunity to turn things around and get us into the game. I think it certainly worked. It got the crowd into it, you know, and it's a big point in the game.
And how do you take this now into next weekend against Nottingham Panthers?
You know, for us, it's about consistency, and we have to find it. You know, we've shown that we can do some things really well. Again, we'll go back to work, watch some tape this week on some of the defensive mistakes. But offensively, I thought we did a lot. We created a lot. We got contributions from up and down the lineup, which was key. You know, so offensively, it was a great game for us.
That's great. Thanks, Jeff.
Cheers. Thank you.
There we go. Jeff Mason with Steve Rinkside after a 6-3 victory over the Glasgow Clan. Complete turnaround from last night in Glasgow. And while you're watching that, I can tell you, Matthew Waugh wins man of the match for the Glasgow Clan. There he is. He's to take a photo as well. High five with the wee fella. Personally, if it was me, I might have gone for Shabbat. But there you go. Okay, so the official Supporters Club Player of the Month for November. Drum roll, please. Elijah Bariga gets the recognition of the Stars fans for the month of November. No surprise, banging him in left, right and centre. Got his very own song here as well. So we'll get the Man of the Match award for you. He's got that one as well. Two goals from him this evening. Hard the finish at the end of a tremendous move from the stars. Semyonov and Dow combine up the centre of the DIA. And Elijah Burry got on the doorstep to knock it home. So it's Rat and Barriga, man of the match awards this evening. The Stars will celebrate with the fans then.